teachers.
Reading words and choosing letters.
Reader and his friends will help us learn together. Off to Wordville, soon we will be reading better. Yeah! Let's go!
Hi, my name is Reader Rabbit.
And I'm Sam. Sam the Lion.
Welcome to the Songs of the Learning Company.
Let's start learning!
Knock on the door, count up to three. Listen for what the answer will be. If you know the secret numbers, you can get inside. This is the place you want to be. With all your friends, just look and see. Here is where the numbers are your guide.
And you can count on me. And I can count on you.
You'll learn to use your numbers in everything you do. Well, it's just
1, 2, 3, and then you're on your way. You can be a member of the counting club today.
Come on inside, look all around. Up in the trees, down on the ground. Animals are playing hide and seek everywhere. You be the one to make them come out. Then count them up, that's what it's about. When you do, we'll all go dancing there.
And you can count on me. And I can count on you.
You'll learn to use your numbers in everything you do. Well, it's just
1, 2, 3. And then you're on your way. You can be a member of the counting club today.
Along. It's time to eat. I know a place that can't be beat. It's a wicky-wacky restaurant. Come in and take a look. Reader Rabbit is the waiter and the dog is the cook. They need some help to make the food. And what they cook is up to you. The first letter in a word, that's what counts. So it's time to learn the letters and their sounds.
Nothing could be finer than the ABC Diner. It's where a little eating can start you into reading. Listen to a word and pick the sound you heard. If you get the right letter, then the food will taste better.
Vanilla fudge ice cream is really, really yummy. But a lemon mustard pizza,
look out for your tummy.
Here's a hint from Ed the Hound. Every letter has a name and a sound. W is wuh, H is huh. And J is just, so here is how you should play. Say the words in a sort of funny way. Like a wuh, wuh, watermelon, huh, huh, ham, banana and jam.
Nothing could be finer than the ABC Diner. It's where a little eating can start you into reading. Get into the mood and make some funny food. If you don't need it, then Scraps will eat it.
It's lots of fun when you play and learn your letters in a wiki-wacky way. You can do it all and be a big success, and it doesn't matter if you make a mess.
Hi-ho, the ABC Diner. Everybody's itching to get into the kitchen. We love the ABC Diner. Everybody wants to take a turn. Because we're hungry, hungry to learn.
My name is Mr. Monkey, and I live up in a tree. I want to learn to read because I'm really smart, you see. As soon as I can learn my shapes, my reading will get better. Because I know that shapes are things that make up all the letters. I try to sort them all just right so I can take a break. But every time I'm almost done, my shack begins to shake. Ooh-wee. So good, and put my toys away like I should. But when I do, just before I'm through, something always starts to shake my shack, and then my toys are in a mess again.
A herd of rhinos or a lightning bolt.
It seems that something always gives me a jolt.
A giant tornado or a swarm of bees.
Sometimes an elephant will sneeze, and so I shout, can you help me out? You need to help me sort the toys just right. Then maybe I can get some sleep at night. It's fun for you, 'cause all you need to do is take a look at the toy I snatch and put it where there is a match. Sound.
Put the toy with the ones that are alike.
That's the way to do it right. And when you do it, that's all there is to it. I'll turn off the light and then I'll sleep all night. Oh no, here it comes. Ah, nuts, it's a mess again. But I don't care, 'cause you'll be there. I know that I can fix my toys again, 'cause you can help me and you're my friend. Hip hooray! Now it's time to play. Everybody make a lot of noise, then we'll go and sort the toys.
Special way.
can actually wake up your brain and help you learn?
Really? Can we do some?
Sure! The Jolly Jamboree!
Hello there!
Hello there!
It's time to play!
Hooray!
Let's see if you can follow me and do the Jolly Jamboree! Clap your hands! Laugh out loud!
Ha ha ha!
Stamp your feet! Then turn yourself around! Now everybody, hut, two, three! It's time for you to march with me! We'll march just like we're in a band! Cross and touch our knees with our hands. Now march, two, three, four. Cross and touch your knees. Good. Hut, two,
three, four.
Very good. Clap your hands. Laugh out loud.
Ha, ha, ha.
Stamp your feet. Then turn yourself around. Now make your hand a buzzy bee and do the lazy eight with me. Watch that bee fly all around as you make a buzzy sound.
In the Reading Development Library, you can write letters to the main characters, and they'll write you back.
And sometimes they'll even sing you a song.
I would like to sing about beanstalks, to sing a beanstalk song. But I think it would be really neat if the beanstalk sang along. It might seem funny to think that a beanstalk can sing. But if a beanstalk can grow right through the clouds, it can do almost anything.
If I had a princess, if I were royalty, if I had a kingdom as far as I could see, we would be so happy, as happy as can be. We'd live happily ever after, the princess and the pea.
I'm a very simple king, and I really don't ask for much. Just happiness for my daughter, and oh yes, the golden touch. I really don't ask for much.
Golden touch, golden touch.
I really don't ask for much.
Golden touch, golden touch.
That shiny, sparkly, rich stuff is what I love to clutch. I want to make lots of gold, I need a golden touch.
Granting wishes makes me really happy. I can make all your wishes come true. I certainly hope that my teeth are their whitest when I grant a wish for you. So I'll brush my chappers left and right. Then I'll be doing business in style. And if I grant you wishes late at night, you can dance by the light of my smile.
Quill and I would love to play some leapfrog. if we could make up the game we play. Swans and toads love to play together, but we don't move in the same way. We're always leaping and flying. That's the way we get around. Yes, we're flying and leaping. That's the way we get off the ground.
That's the end of side one.
There are more songs on side two.
See you there.
We're on the road of stories and words. It's our interactive journey. Oh, look and see what fun there will be. Let's follow the reading road.
That was the theme from the interactive reading journey.
Let's listen to the theme from Interactive Reading Journey 2.
Here we go on down the road, three friends on a vacation. Travel plans to distant lands in search of imagination.
Once you learn to read, then you can start writing.
You can even write songs.
In the Ultimate Writing and Creativity Center, we give you lots of song ideas about lots of things.
Like coyotes, volcanoes, dinosaurs, spiders,
jaguars, bananas,
even asteroids!
I'm a spider, you know I'm really big and hairy, but I keep the beat with my little hairy feet.
I'm a desert reptile, and I have a certain style. You see, I think it's lots of fun to be lazy in the sun. It really makes me
way out in the ocean where the big boats sail. You can hear my music, I'm a-singing the back way.
Thank you very much.
I am a satellite. I work both day and night. I help you hear and see with your phone and your TV.
Jaguar lives in the jungle there. To see a jaguar is very rare. The capybara is a giant rat. It makes a meal for these giant cats.
Wherever I roam, I'm always at home, 'cause I carry my house on my back. Yes, I do.
When you look at the earth from space,
floating on the Amazon, come along with me.
I have a stinger in my tail, but I'm not like a honeybee. My poison can kill or make you ill. You'd better keep away from me.
I'm a climbing vine, and I climb so high. Grab a hold of me and you can swing through the sky.
I'm an emerald boa, I live up in the trees. When I find my dinner, first I bite, then I squeeze.
Many, many years ago, I used to walk around, but all that's left of me are bones and footprints in the ground.
eyes. You can be starstruck with stars in your eyes. There's got to be a millionaire.
I'm a big volcano. Please don't get me mad, 'cause I can blow my top kaboom and it would make me glad. I spew big clouds of ash into the air and think it's funny, and then I take big rocks and squish them down till they get runny.
Coyote howls, coyote cries, coyote's voice echoes under western skies.
And now, the interactive math journey.
Tally Cat, she is a lot like you. She's wondering about what math can do. Come on along. Come on along. Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path, swinging into action.
Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path, patterns and subtraction.
Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path, fractions and addition.
Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path to meet the math magician.
Come on along.
Come on along.
We will find that math is cool to do. We'll see the world exploring new things too. Come on along. Come on along. Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path, swinging into action.
Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path, patterns and subtraction.
Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path, fractions and addition.
Come on along.
Tally's going on the math path to meet the math magician.
Come on along.
Take a journey on the math path.
Come on.
Take a journey on the math path.
Let's go.
Take a journey on the math path.
All right.
Take a journey on the math path.
Come on.
Take a journey on the math path.
Let's go.
Take a journey on the math path.
All right.
Take a journey on the math path.
Come on.
Take a journey on the math
path. You and I, my mirror image, we live side.
Less tries to sell all the sugar and spice. Mr. Moore and Mr. Less
Mr. Moore and Mr. Less are under a lot of stress. 'Cause if Mr. Moore managed to increase the sum, Mr. Less, how'd you guess, will decrease the number. Mr. Less and Mr. Moore can't raise or lower the score. 'Cause when Mr. Moore fast forwards, he will find Mr. Less is pressing rewind. Adding to the count will increase your amount, as adding seems to do. But taking away happens every day. To take it all back, all you do is subtract. Mr. Less and Mr. Moore can't seem to change the score. And when Mr. Moore starts adding, it's a fact, Mr. Less will always subtract.
I put my best foot forward, I move inch by inch. I'd walk a million miles, it would be a cinch. I'm in my own backyard, measuring up my landscape. I'm a fat-tailed beaver with a measuring tape. They call me Measuring Mac, and I'm here to say that you can measure anything in any kind of way. You can measure with a shovel, with a boot, or with a chain. You can measure at your leisure if your units keep the same. You can measure at your leisure if your units keep the same. They call me Measuring Mac. I measure everywhere I roam, and I can parlez-vous on the microphone. I measure trees for a house as the winter time neared. When my tape measure suddenly disappeared, I tried to guess the length, but I knew I was in trouble. So I looked around and I measured with a shovel. For the smaller pieces, my shovel wouldn't do. So I pulled off my boot and I used my shoe. They call me Measuring Mac, and I'm here to say that you can measure anything in any kind of way. You can measure with a shovel, with a boot, or with a chain. You can measure at your leisure if your unit keeps the same. You can measure at your leisure if your units keep the same. They call me Measuring Mac. I measure everywhere I roam, and I can parlez-vous on the microphone.
If you got three and you need three more, then you got six, but you need three more. Then you got nine, but you need three more. Then you got 12, that's three times four. Well, you could add, but adding takes so long. And though it's sad, you might get it wrong. So adding and adding and adding and adding is driving you out of your mind. Try out multiplication, it'll save you a lot of time. If you got five and you need five more, then you got 10, but you need five more. Then you got 15, but you need five more. Then you got 20, that's five times four. Well, you could add, but adding takes so long. And though it's sad, you might get it wrong. So adding and adding and adding and adding is driving you out of your mind. Try out multiplication, it'll save you a lot of time. Try out multiplication, it'll save you a lot of time.
It's late at night and in the street, we cats are on the prowl, scratching, sniffing, and exploring everything we see.
When suddenly we stop, because we hear a great big growl.
Is it a dog?
No, it's my stomach. I'm hungry.
All at once we all let out a cry. Meow, 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 meow. For our favorite food, he's a boy.
'Cause we love a
pepperoni, mozzarella, ham, and provolone.
No ricotta, but some other.
Hey, I want bologna.
Peppers, anchovies, salami.
And the winner's meal, I'm done.
We cover everything with lots of parmesan. La 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 la, la 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 la, lots of parmesan. Hey!
Suddenly we realize we're headed for big trouble. 'Cause each of us would like to eat up all the pizza pie.
We need to find a way to solve this problem on the double.
Or there will be a cat fight.
I'm the first. She's gonna fly.
If we don't make it fair,
I'm gonna lose some hair.
It's a time for action.
Time to make a fraction.
Because the number on the top will tell how many that we want. The number on the bottom tells how many we have in all. A fraction gives us what we need to know, and that is why fractions help us pick a perfect piece of pizza pie. La 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 la, la 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 la, piece of pizza pie. Hey!
We count up all the cats there are before we slice the pizza. 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the number in all.
Then we need to keep a track of how much each cat eats. That's the number on the top, as you may recall.
One for me, one for you. 1 and 1 is 2.
That's the fraction 2/4, so we know there's more.
Mamma mia, it's fair.
And I'm not gonna lose my hair.
Oh, the number on the top will tell how many that we want. The number on the bottom tells how many we have in all. A fraction gives us what we need to know, and that is why fractions help us pick a perfect piece of pizza pie. Fractions help us pick a perfect piece of pizza.
That's all for now. This is Reader Rabbit.
And Sam the Lion.
We're from the Learning Company.
And we'll see you in the Learning Kingdom.